Hi everyone, welcome to my channel. We're doing your reading for today. Before we start, I just want to give you guys a brief intro. I'll be using the Cannoli Tarot for today. That's that one. And the Starseed Oracle card for the three things that would be helpful for you that is going to be revealed. There is a new channel, which is a vlog channel, where I teach and I coach. The latest episode is going to be in the description box down there if you click it. It's the six things that you need for cleansing and healing and manifestation. I made a list and it's going to be found on the other channel at Sal Biadora. This is the mid-month. So the mid-month, I make this. This is my own way of monthly because right now it's officially Aries season. The 14th is the start of, you know, of the sun moving to Aries. Remember, I follow sidereal, so we look at the planets. Right now, the sun is in Aries, and that's where we start the zodiac. So this is the mid-month, and the mid-month will cover from 30 days from that. There is going to be an extended. It's going to be in the description box. I read there further the situation and different scenarios so that you can make a better judgment. And anything else that you need for classes and tarot, webinar, it's also going to be in the description box. I highly suggest downloading the two apps that I have, which is one to get your birth chart, because I will be teaching soon on how to read through your ascendants, moon, you know, and all these planets on YouTube. So make sure you already download that. The other app that I have is Align, and that one gives you your own personal transit prediction every day. It will show you how to schedule different remedies, different things that can be helpful for you as far as transit. And it's very helpful because it's in your phone and you can just read through it and you already know how the planet is affecting you. Those two apps is going to be in the description box. Now, let's begin with your reading. Hi Aquarius, welcome. Let's start your reading. Let me just get the tarot for you guys. Let's begin. We're gonna look at your situation and their side. You first. Here we go. The Hermit, seeking answers, looking for a spiritual path, trying to see what is life out there. This is your situation. Wishing for the one, that's a star card. That's you. Someone could be wishing for you. You could be wishing for another aqua. This is trying to find your divine path. This is not an easy path. This is, nobody goes this stage. But the whole world right now is in the Hermit. They're trying to rethink their self. Hermit is just showing that you're in isolation, join the group, right? You're trying to understand the whole thing, everything happening around you by connecting, because that's the Merkaba. Merkaba is an instrument for us to communicate with God. So you're having a deep soulful connection, but more of looking for answers, trying to understand what's the meaning of all this. You're going deeper and deeper to spirituality. Mm-hmm. You have the Knight of Rods. It seems that someone came into your life and someone left you. And that's why you wondered, is there something wrong? Not about you. This doesn't damper your confidence. You're asking about, is there something wrong between the two of you? Because the Knight of Rods has left. You want to know why. And that's why you're in isolation. Eight of Swords. So this caught you blindsided. You didn't see it, you didn't expect it, never in your wildest dream that you have experienced this. Can be being ghosted. Eight of Swords can be that you are in denial. You're still wondering. There's still stress about this person. It can be a younger person that has done this to you. And you're finding yourself clueless. Eight of Swords. Not an Alicia Silverstone clueless, because that's so fetch. But totally puzzled. Eight of Swords. You're puzzled about this person. What happened? Why they go? Why they just come in and out of your life? Mm-hmm. Let's see your opinion. Three of Swords. The Six of Wands. I feel like it's an energy of a playa. Like a flav. Mm-hmm. And this is your opinion, is like you feel betrayed by them. And Six of Wands, when they want you, they want you, they want to text you, they want to text you. And this is where the betrayal comes from. It's not actually a third party, it's their action is the betrayal. They're using you just for their own fun, their own time. It's if you are a turkey, you know, like they're the filling. They just stuff you, you know. Not that I'm hungry and not that it's Thanksgiving, but you're a turkey filling to them. It's, you know, the turkey is not complete without the filling. Oh no, they're the turkey, you're the filling, sorry. So they're the turkey, you're the you know, the bread thingy, right? So that's what they get from you. So you're being used in Thanksgiving here, you know. The person just, but we all know, we need the, you know, we need that feeling. Okay. So let's see. Is it a feeling? I forgot what it's called. Yeah, but you understand, right? Let's see here. Now, their situation, Four of Pentacles, Five of Wands, and the Ace of Pentacles. So the person is hard to deal with is because they're not emotionally available, and the Five of Wands, it appears there's a lot of drama and conflict just to get something from them. Ace of Pentacles is normally a message of date, going out, meeting, being official, and moving things forward to something stable. That's something that is so hard to give to you. Mm-hmm. Oh, stuffing, not feeling. There you go. Okay, see, I'm not yet, you know, hungry. So, they're the turkey, you're the stuffing. Okay. And the turkey is not complete without the stuffing. That's how I analyze relationship. I'm the cranberry. I'm the binder of everything. Okay. So, they refuse to give you a chance. They refuse to hear you out. For them, it's just like, it's irrelevant. Your opinion is irrelevant. Your action is irrelevant. It's about them. You could be dealing with a younger person, that's why. Mm-hmm. They haven't really seen, you know, better days or what the relationship is. Let's see their opinion. Ace of Swords and Four of Swords. Their opinion of this is their voice has to be heard. They have a say. Because you're claiming that you got betrayed. For them, there's a truth behind to this. You know how they say, there's always two sides of the story, but Sal's story is the only thing that we need to hear. Mm-hmm. Because that's what they're saying. They have a side to this. Because they got Four of Swords. They're recovering from the heartache. So you're not the only person who's heartbroken here. You make sense? Mm. I was watching This Is Us. And there was a pregnant girl, of course the girl, right? She lost the baby and she's saying, I lost a baby. And then of course the husband, he was trying to recover from it. And then he said like, I'm part of it. I know it's not my, you know, blood and whatever, but I'm also part of it. So here it's like that. They're not pregnant, but they're being a BITCH. They're claiming that they got hurt. They're part of the relationship also. Mm. That's the three helpful revelations. First is Star Family. You're part of a team of souls calling support. If you're feeling lonely, this is the best time to talk to relatives, your mom, your siblings, your niece, nephew, cousins, best friend, neighbor, whatever that you need. If you're feeling sad and lonely, it's best to get in touch. Mm-hmm. There are people who can help you out. When I see this, not them, okay? Other people. Weight of the world. Boundaries, let it go. It's not yours to carry. Okay. So that's that one. Ooh, look at that. She's resting right there. So whatever their problem is, it's not for you to take care. Remember how they're saying, how this person is saying that you, that they also have a say for you right now. Don't deal with it. It's not your problem. You have bigger things that you're dealing with. You have your own self to deal with. And the weight of the world, let it go. Let it go. This is Eloisa, a Filipino version of Frozen. Let It Go by Eloisa. Mm-hmm. Let's see. Oh, and Earth Pulsing. Pulse of the Mother. Slow down, time in nature. This card comes out every time someone is hurt. I've noticed that. This oracle is magical. So, it's just showing that take some time out. I know you can't go out and enjoy the earth, you know, and the planet. But it's showing here the hermit is really trying to seek yourself being grounded. Okay? So if you need some cleansing, I remember that video that I did. So this is what it's showing. You need some time to heal, to let go of the person. They really did a number on you. Okay. So I'll continue this reading. Link down there in the description box for the extended. Have a wonderful day. Bye. I'm going to be looking at Venus for now. It's going to give me my own personal reading for Venus. The first part up there that you are seeing, that's for you. And then it's going to give you all the helpful information as far as the transit for the whole period of time that Venus is going to be in that specific house. All this and more. This is the first part. So I'm just letting you know, it gets more exciting. Make sure you click in the description box my affiliate link. And together, we can plan ahead. To texting, messaging you, hearing from you. You understand that messaging you brings them happiness. And an empress does not build a castle. So it's looking like they have to do it on their own. Temperance, Four of Pentacles, and the Hangman. Before you reconcile with this person, because they're gonna